您现在收看的是华视教育文化频道，
接下来要播出的是英文文法与修辞一。
欢迎收看英文文法与修辞第五讲次，动词的规则与不规则变化。我们先来看一下讲次目标。我们这个讲次是要探讨英文动词的系统定义和分类。我们希望帮同学理解英文动词现在式的原型变成过去式以及过去分词它的规则变化。我们还要分析英文动词三态的不规则变化。现在我来为同学做一下本周的摘要。动词的功能是用来询问事物，表现行为动作，或者是陈述某一种状态。英文动词的变化可分规则和不规则三态变化。规则变化是动词现在式原形加上 d 或者 ed， 就变成它的过去式和过去分词。不规则三态变化则有AAA 三态没有变化，或是 AAB 动词现在式原形和过去式一致， ABA 动词现在式原形和过去式过去分词一致， ABB 动词它的过去式和过去分词一致， ABC 的话是三态皆不同这些变化。好，我们现在来请美国老师 Steven 教授为我们来朗读课文。
Since there is no inflection and conjugation in Chinese verbs, most Chinese EFL students have problems with English verbs, especially the regular and irregular verbs.In the following, we will introduce some rules of English verbs and their usage. Regular verbs form their past tense and past participle by adding ed or d to the present simple base forms. For instance, for the verb drown, its past tense is drowned and its past participle is also drowned.The following are three example sentences. You should wear a life-saving jacket if you don't want to drown yourself in these rapids. Mr. Clinton drowned his meal in gravy. Three boys have drowned this summer. If verbs end in a consonant plus y,We change the Y to I and add ED to form their past tense and past participle. The following is examples of this kind. Study hard so that you can pass the exam. My little sister studied English for 3 years in junior high school. I have studied French for 3 hours.If a verb ends in a vowel plus y, just add ed to form the past tense and past participle. Examples, play, played, played, employ, employed, employed. For verbs with a final e, we just add a d to form the past tense and past participles. The following are some examples. advise, advised, advised. I advise you to do the exercise regularly. They advised that we should stay at home when sandstorms come. Change, changed, changed. Please let me know if you change your mind. Laura King changed her name to Marilyn Monroe under a fortune teller's advice. You haven't changed a bit since I saw you 2 years ago. Irregular verbs are more complicated. The following tables can help you understand the rules of the present simple base form, past tense, and past participles of irregular verbs. AAA. Bet, bet, bet. Burst, burst, burst. Broadcast, broadcast, broadcast. Cost, cost, cost. Cut, cut, cut. AAB. Beat, beat, beaten. ABA. Become, became, become. Come, came, come. ABB. Bend, bent, bent. Bring, brought, brought. Feed, fed, fed. Have, had, had. Lead, led, led. Sit, sat, sat. Tell, told, told. Use, used, used. Wake, woke, woke. Weep, wept, wept. Win, won, won. A, B, C. B, was or were, been. Bite, bit, bitten. Blow, blew, blown. Break, broke, broken. Choose, chose, chosen. Do, did, done. Draw, drew, drawn. Drink, drank, drunk. Eat, ate, eaten. Fall, fell, fallen. Freeze, froze, frozen. Give, gave, given. Go, went, gone. Grow, grew, grown. Know, knew, known. Ride, rode, ridden. Swim, swam, swum. Take, took, taken. Tear, tore, torn. Wear, worn, worn. Write, wrote, written.
好，谢谢 Steven 老师。让我们休息一下，待会我来为同学讲解课文。好， since there's no inflection and conjugation in Chinese verbs, 由于在中文的动词里面我们没有词尾变换，还有主词动词之间需要配合， most Chinese EFL students, 所以大多数台湾的同学他学习英文的时候，他 have problem with English verbs, 对英文的动词都会产生问题。Especially the regular and irregular verbs, 特别是这个规则和不规则的三态变化。In the following, 那接下来 we will introduce some rules of English verbs and their usage. 我们会介绍一些英文动词的规则，还有它们的用法。那规则变化 regular verbs.A, regular verbs form their past tense and past participle by adding ed or d to the present simple base form. 那规则变化通常是在它的原型后面加上 ed 或者加上 d， 就可以形成它的过去式和过去分词。For instance， 那举例来说 ，For the verb drawn， 我们动词是 drawn 这个哈，淹死或是它的 past tense 过去式是 drowned 加上 ed 哈，它的 past participle 过去分词同样也是加上 ed 是 drowned。The following are three example sentences， 下面三个例句说明。You should wear a life-saving jacket， 你应该穿一个救生衣。If you don't want to drown yourself in these rapids， 假如你不希望在这些急流中溺毙，就不希望淹死的话，最好穿上救生衣。好 ，Mr. Clinton drowned his meal in gravy。克林顿先生他 drowned his meal in gravy。这个 gravy 是肉汁哈，那 drown 在这边就不当淹死，它就变成另外一种的意思，就是说你把你的饮食的食物把它沾满了肉汁，这时候的话就是 drown his meal in gravy 哈。不是把这个饮食物都淹死了，是说把它用肉汁整个覆盖，所以吃的好像很营养。然后它的过去式是加上 ed。再过来 ，three boys have drowned this summer。好，这个夏天啊，已经有三个男孩他淹死了。这过去分词就还是加上 ed drowned。Now, if a verb ends in a consonant y plus y, we change the y to I and add ed to form their past tense. 假如一个动词它的字尾是一个子音加上 y， 那这时候我们就把这个 y 再改成 I， 然后再加上 ed， 就形成它的过去分词。过去式以及过去分词。The following is an example of this kind. 下面就是一个例子。Study hard so that you can pass the exam. 好，你要好好的用功，这样的话才能够 pass the exam。那下来，接着是 My little sister studied English for 3 years.In junior high school， 我的小妹她 studied， 这是这个 y 字尾是 y， 这时候 y 就变成 studied， 那个 d 是一个子音，加上 y， 这时候把 y 改成 i， 再加上 ed 就 studied English for 3 years in junior high school， 在高中，在初中哈，她学英文学了三年。I have studied French for 3 hours. 我已经在这边念法文念了三个小时。If a verb ends in a vowel plus y， 假如一个动词它的结尾是一个母音再加上 y 的时候，这时候 just add ed， 这时候只要加上 ed， 不需要改变 y 哈，母音的时候就不需要做任何改变，就可以加上 ed to form their past tense and past participle， 这样就可以变成它的过去式以及过去分词。好，我们举例来看 ，play 就变成 played， 那这是玩耍 ，employee 雇用，然后 employed。好，再接下来是说，假如这 c， 假如动词。它最后是一个，它的 final 就最后的字尾是一个 e， 我们只要加上 d， 因为它已经是 e 了哈，这时候就可以形成它的 past tense 过去式以及过去分词 past participle。那下面我们给同学举一些例子，像是 advised， 好，例句 ，I advise you to do exercise regularly. 我建议你要规律的做运动。They advised that. 他们过去建议什么呢？建议 we should stay at home. 我们应该待在家里。当什么时候呢？当 sandstorm come， 当这个沙尘暴 sandstorms come， 沙尘暴来的时候。最好待在家里，然后再过来，我们看这个哈 ，change 改变加上 ed changed， 好 ，please let me know if you change your mind， 好，假如你改变心意，要告诉我就通知我 ，let me know， 这是改变的现在式，再过来 ，Laura King changed。她过去改变了 Laura King， 她过去 change her name， 把她的名字哈改成 Marilyn Monroe， 玛丽莲蒙露，然后是 under a fortune teller's advice， 这是因为一个算命师这样子建议的。好，最后这个 changed， 她过去分词哦加上 ed， you haven't changed a bit。你一点都没有改变 ，since I saw you 2 years ago， 从我2年前看到你哈，现在再看你一点都没变。接下来是不规则的变化 ，irregular verbs are more complicated， 不规则动词它更复杂了。The following table can help you understand the rules of the present simple base form。Past tense and past participle of irregular verbs. 那我们下面这个表格可以帮同学了解不规则动词变化的三态：现在式、过去式跟过去分词。那 AAA 就是三态都一样，没有任何变化，是这样。Bet 打赌哈 ，bet bet bet。Burst 是爆炸、破裂，我们就 burst 哈。三态一样 ，broadcast 广播，这都是 broadcast 三态一样 ，cost 是花费，三态一样 ，cut 就是割伤手，这个 cut 切东西都三态一样。再过来 ，aab， 这个时候现在式跟过去式是一样，那过去分词是不同，像 be beat beaten。这个的话是打击哈，好，再过来是 ABA， become became become 变成 ，come came come 来，再过来是 ABB bend， 它是弯曲 ，bend bent bent， 再过来是 bring 拿过来 ，the bring brought brought， feed 是喂。Feed, fed, fed. Have 是有哈 ，have, had, had. 再过来是 lead, led, led. 引导、带领。Sit 是坐下来 ，sit, sat, sat. Tell 是说话，告诉你 ，I'll tell you 这个 tell 哈 ，tell, told, told. 然后 use 是使用，然后 used。Used， 再过来是 wake， 醒来 woke，woked， 再过来是 weep， 哭泣 ，wept，wept，win 是赢，像你那个赢了爱国，就是中乐透哈，或是赢了比赛 ，win，won，won， 再过来是 A B C。be 动词 be 的原型，它的过去式是 was 或是 were， 然后过去分词是 been， bite 是咬，然后它的过去式是 bit， bitten 过去分词， blow 是吹，风怎么吹？ blow bloom blown， break 是打破， break broke broken。再过来是 choose 选择 ，chose chosen。再过来是 do 做 ，did done。 withdraw 是我们讲说抽签或是抽出来 draw, drew, drawn 然后 drink 是喝水饮水 drink, drank, drunk eat 是吃吃东西 ate, eaten fall 是倒下来 fall, fell, fallen 再过来是 freeze 这是冷冻 froze 这是过去式 frozen 过去分词 give 给 gave given 再过来 go 去 went gone grow 是生长长大 grew grown 再过来是知道 know no new known知道的生态然后 write 我们讲骑单车和 write, wrote, written 再过来是游泳 swim, swam, swung 接下来是 take, 拿 take, took, taken 接下来是 tear, 撕碎的撕裂 tear, tore, torn wear 是穿 worn worn 再过来是 write 写 wrote written 好这就是我们的三态我们休息一下待会继续这是文法的用字是分词的意思
2. Drown
这是溺毙
3. Rapids
急流
4. Gravy
这是肉汁的意思
5. Complicated
复杂的
6. Burst
爆炸或者是破裂
7. Broadcast
广播或是播送的意思
8. Beat
打击敲或是冲击
9. Bend
弯曲或者是折弯
10. Tear
这是撕开好接下来是我们的 chat room 时间Stephen, that we have mentioned the last week that for nouns, we don't differentiate between regular and irregular forms. And here, regarding verbs that Chinese students find much more challenging, especially for the regular and irregular that past participle, past tense, that, so we need your help here.
Well, frankly, English irregular verbs are a mess. They always have been. We've always had them. They're part of our heritage. And there isn't any simple, straightforward general rule for telling whether a verb is regular or irregular, or if it's irregular, what kind of irregular verb it is, how its past tense and past participle forms are related to the present tense forms. Every decent dictionary of English has a list of these somewhere. And the only thing that a responsible student of English can do is to buckle down and memorize the stuff. It's not easy, it's hard work. I will admit that. And it's hard for everybody. Not just for people like you, for whom English is a second language, it's hard for us, for people for whom English is a first language, a primary language. I can remember my children when they were very young complaining to me, why is it love, loved, loved, but buy, bought, or fall, fell, fallen.
好，那基本上我们在这里是希望帮同学整理出来一个文法的规则，找出来是不是有比较简单的方法来学英文哈。那我们谈到动词，因为我们的动词的话，没有所谓过去式、过去分词都需要变化规则不规则一大堆的变化哈。所以在这边的话 ，Steven 老师是跟我们讲说，不只是外国人，就即使是英文的母语人士，也是对这个是非常的觉得头痛。他基本上的话 ，it's a mess， 就是说这个乱七八糟。虽然你们好像试着说 a a a a b c， 然后 a b a 等等，他说好了，他说可是事实上这是一场混乱，所以不要觉得说好像很头痛。即使是美国人，他自己还有他的小孩子，就从小长大都要在那边一直背，所以唯一就是背。那他们有很多游戏哈，那还有他的小孩子也是常常跟他抱怨说，为什么这个爱 love 就是 loved 这变成过去式过去分词，可是唱歌或是买东西 buy 就要变成 bought， 那这个 fell 倒下来就变成 fallen， 他小孩子也是一直跟他 complain 啊。
There is a palliative. This what I've said is that.This is hard for every student of English to learn this stuff. But once we've mastered it, we find them fun. We tell jokes about them. We play games with them. And that's why there are so many of them, I think. Over time,Individual verbs may shift gradually from being irregular verbs to being regular verbs, but some other verbs may go the other way. For instance, 300 years ago, the verb catch was a regular verb. Its past tense was catched. But then sometime during the 18th century, somebody got the idea that caught sounded better.Or at least sounded more fun. And more people agreed with this, and it became fashionable. And finally, by sometime in the early 19th century, caught was the normal form.
好，所以 Steven 老师说哈，他原则上的话哈，那这种他们自己也常常笑，就是他母语人士，所以也会有很多笑话，就是说这三态怎么样乱变化的。那还有就是会玩一些游戏。那还有他说，从历史的观点来讲，也会有改变。那有一些字它是不规则变化变规则，那有一些字是从规则变化不规则。他举个例子，像是 catch 哈，他在300年前是。Catched 只要加 ed 哈，那可是慢慢的到了18世纪的时候，有的人觉得说 catch 好像变成 caught 是过去式，比较好像时髦，比较怎么样，所以就从本来是规则变化加 ed， 可是18世纪慢慢就变成 catch 过去式 caught， 所以慢慢的哈就从规则变化变成不规则。
Another example, the verb.Dive. Up until about 100 years ago, it was a regular verb. The past tense was dived. As far as I know, it's still a regular verb in British English. But in America, a variant became popular. We started saying dove instead. And so this gets added to the small differences.Between the British and American dialects of English. I admit that as an American, to me, it's obvious that the past tense is dove, and I have some difficulty saying dived.
好，除了历史上规则不规则哈，这样子变来变去，那还有英美人士之间也有不同，像 dive， 我们讲说潜水哈这个字，那英国人的话是。Dive 变成规则变化 ，dived， 美国人就是 dive， dove， 都就不规则的变化，所以英美这个动词的差异有的时候也是蛮头痛的哈。不过同学基本上放轻松，慢慢的背，然后有时候玩一些游戏。好，谢谢 Steven 老师，那我们今天就到这里结束，谢谢各位同学收看，下周再会。